두 분과 엔지니어 두 분과 함께 얘기를 나눠볼 텐데요. 프랭카가 어떤 회사인지 그리고 이 틱포드 레이싱 팀을 이제 운영하고 있는 그런 회사인데 제가 좀 몇 가지 질문을 해보고 한국 모터스포츠 팬들에게 네, 프랭카에 대해서 좀 소개를 해보도록 하겠습니다. Yeah, this is Jim from Neotech. Firstly, please introduce to the Korean fans yourself.
Okay. So Sinyo, I'm the head of our Premcar SVT business, which is a new business venture we just started recently. So about 2 to 3 years ago, most of the, or all of the manufacturing, or automotive vehicle manufacturing in Australia ceased. So we've still got very strong engineering divisions here at Ford and General Motors.
Yeah.
But in terms of product build and performance products, the local performance market is effectively doesn't exist anymore.
Right.
So what we've done is we've established this building to sort of give the Australian people an OE level of experience in the performance aftermarket business with our first offering, the Premcar Holy Grail package.
Yeah, and Andrew?
Yes, I'm Andrew Lynch, principal chassis engineer, but now moving to sort of head of programs.
Yep.
So I've been responsible working with Chris. He's been working mainly on the engine side, and I've been developing the chassis handling package for the vehicle.
Yeah, the second question, like few people know Premcar because Ford is not popular in Korea.
Yeah.
And our like Korean motorsports market is much smaller than Australia.
Yeah.
Yeah, so could you give me a quick like introduction just for the Premcar?
So Premcar, the business entity, has been around since about 1996. It was previously called Tickford Vehicle Engineering. In a JV partnership with Ford here. So the Tickford Vehicle Engineering Division was the performance partner of Ford Australia and developed high-performance six-cylinder vehicles and high-performance V8 vehicles in road car form. These vehicles were the basis for the Australian V8 Supercar Championship. So effectively the Tickford road cars were then spun off into the V8 Supercar race series you guys are familiar with. I think it was about 2002, Tickford Vehicle Engineering became Ford Performance Vehicles.
Under the FPV.
FPV.
And ProDrive.
And ProDrive.
And ProDrive.
As well. Andrew's been, I think, a member of FPV, ProDrive.
That was all of them, since 99. So.
99, so he's been around longer than FPV here. And we were responsible for engineering all of the Performance V8 and Turbo 6-cylinder sedans for Australian market. And again, those vehicles were the road versions of the race cars that you can see here today.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. And I heard Premcar is going to produce like GD HO again this time. So can you give a brief introduction of GD HO car, the history of, because a Ford car actually not popular in Korea, unfortunately.
So the GT Falcons basically existed back in the very early supercar days in the early 60s. Effectively, the way it worked back in the day is you went to the dealership, you brought a car off the showroom floor, you drove it to Bathurst and you raced Bathurst in the production car. So the GTHO in particular, the Phase 3 XY model, was the fastest, most powerful and quickest production four-door car anywhere in the world. So, you know, it's a 1971 model car with 380 horsepower. It's legendary in Australia. It's the most effectively desirable car that you can buy.
And now sell for?
Oh, well over $1 million.
They sell for $1 million?
Yeah.
268 original cars, and they are people fight for. I think that was the last of the original HOs, and then I think back in 72 they tried to do a phase four in Australia, went through what they call a supercar scare, and the government effectively stopped Australia producing more of the supercars. Since sort of the late 70s there's always been a desire to produce another GDHO.
What is the meaning of like GDHO?
Well, the HO name actually stands for Handling Options.
Handling Options?
Handling Options. But the reality was it was a... you have more luck turning a boat on the road than one of these. So they were under-tired, under-brake, terrible chassis. They just had these crazy engines in the front of them. Quite dangerous.
Really dangerous.
But I suppose the most recent product we offered under the FPV banner, the Supercharged Coyote V8, there was always a want or a desire from the engineering group to deliver a sort of a modern day HO. And the performance capability was engineered into, you know, supercharged 335 and 351 engines that you see. With the sort of the shutdown of manufacturing and the demise of FPV in the country, sort of the Premcar engineering team have been desperately trying to do what we always wanted to do. And now we've had this opportunity. So, but you know, along with the powertrain upgrade, Andrew yep. and his team, in conjunction with Brett, have developed what yeah. I think is probably...
It's just short drive, but I took the GDHO with Andrew, yeah. but wow, the power.
Yeah, so it's... Yeah.
And handling.
The problem is you're lucky you drove the one with the handling.
Yeah.
The engine on its own, without the upgraded chassis and the brilliant work these guys have done, it is scary.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
It's a handful.
Scary. It's a handful.
Okay, I've heard that, I heard that such a high performance vehicle, we use like Shockworks damper for the chassis upgrade. Yeah. So, and the blade bar too.
Yeah.
Why Premcar choose Shockworks, like among the older, like high quality and famous brands?
Brett's an ex-FPV engineer, and he was absolutely crucial in the development of the FPV
yeah.
chassis and handling packages for the road cars back in the day. And, mm-hmm. and sort of Brett left, you know, Premcar. We were very disappointed to start the Shockworks business up. So, you know, we've mm-hmm. had a very strong relationship with Brett. We know how yeah. talented and capable Brett is, and we know, more importantly, mm-hmm. just how... Yeah. With that product.
So you know all the history that he has.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, and the adjustability yeah. of the dampers with the 12 stage adjustment mm-hmm. sort of gave us a complete range of what we wanted to achieve with the vehicle.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
and working alongside Brett and allowing a little bit of freedom to sort mm-hmm. of tune the springs and the damping force is probably a bit higher than Brett wanted and was scared of. But
yeah.
I think we sort of pushed it and you know, working together was really benefit, which is something you also don't get from other manufacturers. They might just throw you one valve code and, mm-hmm. and that's all you get. But working with Shockworks here and your product, it's so tunable that I think we're able to really develop the car to its full potential mm-hmm. rather than just compromise for something
that was mediocre. We're not an aftermarket offering. We are production level OE engineering team.
Yeah.
Knowing that the Shockworks damper has meeting and exceeded all of our previous FPV and Ford durability requirements, mm-hmm. gives you the confidence that, hey, this is a genuine quality product.
Yeah, right. So have you tried the other brands too on a like GDHO for the comparison?
Look, over the years, I guess we have tried other brands in the vehicle.
Yeah.
And you know, I guess the base car comes with Sax dampers, mono tube. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So which in tunability, they're probably a good, reliable product, but without the adjustability that mm-hmm. you get on the Shockwork dampers. We've tried other sort of lower quality competitors like Bilstein, and really they didn't deliver at the time. They weren't willing to work with us like you have here mm-hmm. and really sort of push that envelope and have no compromises, get to where we want to be and develop the best product. So
adjustability is key for our program uh-huh. because while everyone talks about performance and chassis dynamics, what we find is some customers want cruise and comfort that you get, one end of the spectrum and others our guns theories here, Andrew and Brett, want, precision. Mm-hmm. And they get that at the other end. So you can go from, on road to in comfort, because most Australian roads aren't very good, to mm-hmm. full out track bias.
Yeah.
And something that we always wanted to do with a production car, but we were always restricted with spring rates and...
Yeah.
It was always a compromise as well. Uh-huh. So, one vehicle we brought out a little soft, and you get the press say it's too soft, some of the customers like it.
Yeah.
The next version you bring out, the R-spec is a little bit hard, so we never really could find... They mm-hmm. complain about the ride, so it was always that balance.
On level, we've got compliance and beautiful road manners, and on the other hand, we've got... Brilliant on track.
Yeah.
It's the perfect solution for us.
Yeah.
Thank you. And in Korea, Hyundai and Kia are interested in like high performance vehicle recently so much.
Yeah.
Like Hyundai launched their like that. I think it will be so fun make a high performance version of them like with Korean cars. So why don't you join us for the Korean market?
Love to.
Yeah, I think we had that discussion yesterday as well about this sort of topic that might come up. And I guess looking at it, we know that we can put the OE level of expertise into whatever vehicle we tune. So it's not just about extracting the most out of every engine. It's about extracting the most up into a limit that's really durable and really containable. Right. So similar for suspension, you can go and change every bush to solid mm-hmm. rose joints, but it's going to fall apart after a certain amount of time.
Right.
It's going to be noisy. It's going to compromise. Yeah. So. We've got the knowledge to be able to push the vehicle to achieve the handling targets of what we want, but still maintain that OE quality and reliability.
Yeah, and all the protections that are built into the factory systems and very quickly reverse engineer the factory limitations so that we don't exceed the OE level of durability and testing exceeds anything that's done in the aftermarket, and, uh-huh. and the manufacturers have the processes and the capability to make sure that the products they release are right. So
yeah, actually, like after we our company also bought like Stinger and Hyundai and like all the like sports version of the Hyundai and Kia, yeah. and after we changed the suspension and brakes, and then there's nothing that we can do more after than that. Yeah. So like I was, yeah, I was
so you
thinking.
Ship us a Korean car, yeah. ship us a high performance car.
Yeah.
And then these guys can.
Yeah, right. Do they sell Stinger over here?
Yeah, yeah,
we
yeah.
do.
Yeah.
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 Very
yeah.
popular.
Yeah, yeah.
So there's definitely more room, I think, especially because we've got the analytical tools, the CFD analysis, the GT power, if we wanted to to sort of bring the air intake system, the exhaust system up to sort of a higher level to what's in that car. We can look at the compliance of the bushes and really determine where the handling can be improved, where the tow control can really be maintained and get that precision in the steering even better.
It's going to be so fun if it happens, yeah. I would try to do, yeah.
Talk to Mr. Lee, send us a car.
Okay, I hope that I can keep introducing about Premcar to Korean motorsports fan, even just for car fans.
Yeah.
Yeah, and make a high performance Hyundai and Kia cars for the future. Yeah, and lastly, this is a last like question, and please say hello to Korean car fans, because Korea is a small company, but we have a massive population. Yeah, so and then there's a lot of people who love the car. So please say hello to and hoping to see like for the future. Yeah.
Hey guys, hope to see you out here, and maybe you can get your sales in one of our Holy Grail packages, and
hope to
blast and scare yourself.
Yeah.
Scare yourself fun.
Yeah, and we look forward to working with everyone there and developing some cars that the local guys could, you know, we could enhance and really you guys can have some fun.
And getting you guys to come to Korea to see the market.
Oh yeah, yes please. Better, yes please. Big. Yeah, when we have like our biggest race.
When's the big race?
Like big start from April, like every month. Yeah, one per month. Yeah.
Great.
Yeah, that'd be great. Yeah. Okay. So, thank you for the time today, and then hope to see you very soon.
Sounds
yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah.
Thanks very much.